Nowadays, I try to work from home as much as I can, but sometimes I need to go into the office, which means it's more convenient for me to use a laptop. And on an average working day, I'm logged into these online services. I use Zoom and WebEx to talk to my colleagues in HQ, I use Microsoft Teams to talk to our US colleagues, Messenger to talk to my friends and family, I use Google Drive for my personal files, I use Nextcloud for company files. You get the point, you're probably in the same shoes. If I'm in the office and I walk into a UC room to have a video conference call, I can connect my laptop to the meeting room display using an HDMI cable, but I will not have access to the USB peripherals, which means I will have to use the built-in webcam of my laptop, which is located here above the keyboard, which is a horrible place for a webcam. I mean, who approved this? I will also need to use the built-in keyboard and the touchpad of my laptop, and the microphone might pick up the noise when I'm typing. And if I'm low on battery, then I will need to look for my charger and plug it in, so it's not convenient. If I decide to use the meeting room PC instead of my laptop, that means I will have access to all the USB peripherals in the room, including the keyboard, the mouse, and the webcam, but that also means I will have to log into at least 5 of those services I mentioned before that I will need during the call or that I will need to do the call itself. And 5 doesn't sound a lot, does it? But do you know how much time I would spend in a year waiting for meeting room PCs to boot up and logging into all of those services? Some of which have two-factor authentication, by the way, which means I will have to sit there and wait for the text message to arrive with the authentication code. 25 hours. That's right, I would spend 3 entire working days waiting for meeting room PCs to boot up, logging in, logging out, and shutting down. But those compromises are over, because do you know how I start my meetings nowadays? I walk into a UC room, I take a cable like this, I plug it in, and that's it. I'm all set. Well, obviously not all set. The other end of the cable is plugged into this. This is Taurus UCX, a USB-C enabled one-box UC room connectivity solution for video, audio, USB, control, and Ethernet. It's an entire lineup of devices, so there are different I/O sizes and connector combinations available, but this particular unit is the 4x2 HC30, which means it's a 4x2 switch, and H stands for HDMI and C stands for USB-C. Two of those 4 inputs are HDMI 2.0 and 2 are USB-C, and the 2 output ports are also HDMI 2.0. All ports support 4K60 RGB and all embedded audio formats, but that's nothing special nowadays. What is special is its USB functionality. All Taurus UCX devices have a 4-port super-speed USB hub built-in, where you can attach USB peripherals, such as webcam, keyboard, mouse, or really any kind of USB peripheral. And it also has a USB host switch built in. A host switch works almost backwards as a USB hub, meaning it has 1 port for USB peripherals, but 4 ports for host computers, and it can switch which of those 4 computers should have access to the USB peripherals. So if you put a USB hub and a USB host switch together, you can attach multiple peripherals and multiple host computers, and you can decide which of those computers should have access to the USB peripherals. And that's exactly what we did in Taurus UCX, and I'll show you how it works in a minute, but first, let's talk a little bit about USB-C. USB-C is very convenient for laptop users, but it also has a lot of potential for UC room application. USB-C allows us to use the same cable to carry video, audio, and USB data, and also provide charging for the laptop. And with Taurus UCX, we took USB-C one step further because we implemented USB Ethernet bridges for the 2 USB-C inputs. And that means Taurus UCX provides a permanent wired Ethernet connection to the 2 USB-C hosts. So there's no need to fiddle around with wireless networks anymore, you just plug in the USB-C cable and you're always online. Alright, enough talk, let's see it in operation. For the demonstration, we are going to use a single display device and 2 sources. The first source is this meeting room PC. It's an Intel NUC type computer, which is quite common in UC room environments. It is connected to Taurus UCX using this black HDMI to HDMI cable, this blue super speed type A to type B cable, and this yellow Cat5 cable for Ethernet connection. And the other source is going to be the Dell laptop, which will only use a single USB-C to USB-C cable. Our USB peripherals will be a Huddly Go, which is a super speed USB webcam, a wireless keyboard, and a wireless mouse. When there are no sources connected, or the connected sources are powered off, like the meeting room PC right now, Taurus UCX can show a welcome screen like this, which is actually an image file stored in its memory, and you can design your own image file and upload it. and it can include the meeting room name, the company logo, and any text-based information that is meant to help people start the meeting or use the meeting room equipment. Now I'm going to turn on the meeting room PC and demonstrate the auto-switching and the USB follow video functionality. As soon as Taurus UCX realizes that there is an active video signal on one of its input ports, it's going to replace the welcome screen with that video signal, and the host switch is also going to give access to the PC and it's going to be able to use the USB peripherals. So now I can take this keyboard, which is connected to the Taurus UCX, and I can type in my password to log in. We will wait for the meeting room PC to finish booting. And I set up Zoom to start automatically, and I can demonstrate that the meeting room PC now has access to the USB webcam by starting a new meeting. And now it's time to connect the laptop using the USB-C cable. And I gave the USB-C input a higher priority, so as soon as the laptop starts sending a video signal, it's going to replace the image of the meeting room PC. And now the host switch also gave access to the USB peripherals to this laptop. So I can use the keyboard to control the laptop, and I can also select the Huddly Go from the list of available cameras. And as I said earlier, if you take a closer look at the battery icon, you can see that the laptop is being charged via the USB-C cable, so I don't need to worry about running out of power in the middle of the video conference and having to connect my charger. Taurus UCX can provide 60 watts of charging through its USB-C ports, and if you're only using one laptop, then it can get the whole 60 watts, and if you're using two laptops, then they can share that power equally. And this icon tells us that the laptop now has a permanent wired Ethernet connection as well. As I mentioned, we have built in two USB Ethernet bridges that operate independently of the host switch. And now let's explore the other connectors and features apart from video and USB, and for that I'm going to use another Taurus UCX unit. Here you can see a 5-pole Phoenix connector for de-embedding any of the incoming video signals, so if you don't want to use the built-in speakers of your display, then you can use this connector to send the audio signal to a dedicated audio system. Here you can see two RJ45 connectors, and the third one is here. At the moment, these ports are connected to the Ethernet switch inside, where the CPU and the two USB-C ports are also connected. But in a future firmware release, we are going to add Ethernet security features. You will be able to define VLANs, and as you can already see by the labels, you will be able to define different roles for the different connectors. Here you can see an 8-pole Phoenix connector for GPIO functions. Six of them are configurable as inputs or outputs. There's a dedicated 5-volt and a ground pin. Next to that, there is an occupancy sensor port, and next to that, you can find two RS-232 ports. These ports will become fully functional with a future firmware release to give Taurus UCX room automation capabilities, such as using the occupancy sensor signal to see when people enter the room, and Taurus UCX can turn the lights on and turn the display on, and when people leave the room, Taurus UCX will be able to turn the entire system off. And last but not least, we are also working on a Dante version. That unit is going to have a fourth RJ45 connector dedicated to Dante functions, so you will be able to send the de-embedded audio directly into a Dante system. If you would like to learn more about this or any other product, go to lightware.com, check out some other product videos, and if you like them, feel free to subscribe. But for now, thanks for watching.